We continue our conversation about Mendel by talking about human traits that appear to contradict his laws. Despite this, his theory of particulate inheritance can still be applied to traits with unexpected outcomes. In this screencast, we will look at colorblindness, blood type, and height, and show how these traits follow Mendel's laws. A sex-linked trait is carried on a sex chromosome. Recall that females have two X chromosomes, and males have an X and a Y chromosome. Therefore, females will have two alleles for a gene, but males will have only one. As you can see in this human karyotype, the Y chromosome is smaller and does not have as many genes as the X chromosome. Color vision is a sex-linked trait that is carried on the X chromosome. Normal vision is dominant, and red-green colorblindness is recessive. Here are the colors that a person with red-green colorblindness sees compared to a person with normal vision. Notice they don't see red and green the way a normal color vision person would. We will use a capital C for normal color vision since it is a dominant trait. The small C will stand for red-green colorblindness. We will underline the small C to distinguish it from the capital C. As stated before, females will have two alleles and males will have one. So we must indicate the sex of the individual by using these letters as superscripts on the X chromosome. So we know the sex of the individual. So a normal vision female can be homozygous with two capital C's, or she may carry a recessive allele. To be colorblind, a female must have two recessive alleles, shown here as two small C's. A male, however, will either have a normal vision allele or a colorblind allele on his X chromosome. There will be no allele on the Y chromosome. So for males, once we know their phenotype, we know their genotype. So can parents who have normal color vision have a colorblind child if the mom is a carrier? Recall that their alleles will segregate during meiosis, so each parent can only pass on one of each in their gametes, as stated in Mendel's law of segregation. A sperm cell with a Y chromosome will not pass on information about color vision, so there is never a superscript on the Y for this trait. So these parents have a 50% chance that a son will be colorblind. Their daughters, however, will all be normal color vision, but have a 50% chance of being a carrier of the colorblindness allele. Another extension of Mendel's laws is blood type, an example of multiple alleles and codominance. Mendel looked at traits that had two alternate forms only, like green and yellow seeds or round and wrinkled seeds. These have two alleles. Blood type has three possible alleles, A, B, and O, and two of these, A and B, are codominant, and both are dominant to O. Codominance means that both alleles will be expressed when they occur together. In the conventional notation for dominant and recessive alleles, we use the capital for the dominant and the lowercase for the recessive allele. We use the letter I for blood types, which stands for isoalleles. Since there are two dominant alleles for blood type, we will use A and B as superscripts on the I. Since there is only one recessive allele, there will not be a superscript on the lowercase I. So those with A and B blood types can be homozygous or heterozygous A or B. But those with AB blood type have one of each of the dominant alleles. And a person with blood type O would have two recessive alleles. When you do the blood typing lab to eliminate suspects in a murder case, you will observe clumping of cells with anti-serum A and anti-serum B. In this photo, you are observing the reaction in fake blood instead of real blood. We test for blood types by adding a serum to the blood. If the blood cells contain a protein that an antibody attacks, the cells will clump together or agglutinate, which you can see here, 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 and here. Blood type A has eight proteins on its cells. But blood type A has antibody B in its serum. Type A cannot have anti-A because that would destroy its own cells. The A antibodies can attach to the A antigens on the surface of the type A blood cells, so agglutination occurs. Likewise, the B antibodies can attach to the B antigens on the type B blood cells, and agglutination would occur as well. Type AB blood has both antigens on its cell surface. So agglutination will occur when both antibodies are present. And since type O possesses no antigens, agglutination will not occur when either antibody is present. Here's a recap of each blood type and the antibodies each has in its serum. So what offspring are possible if one parent is type A and the other is type B and each is heterozygous? Mendel's law of segregation states that each parent will pass on only one allele for blood type. The other parent can only pass on one. Their children can have any possible blood type. A, B, AB, or O. Human height is an example of polygenic inheritance, another extension of Mendel's laws. Height is inherited according to the laws of segregation and independent assortment, but it is determined by more than one gene, and each one can be either dominant or recessive. Because it is polygenic, there is a wide range of possible heights, as you can see in this graph. In addition, height is influenced by the environment of the individual, such as diet and health. Later on, we will discuss at least two other polygenic traits, human skin color and finch beak length. In summary, complex traits that at first do not appear to follow Mendel's laws of segregation and independent assortment, in fact, do follow them. Sex linkage refers to traits carried on the sex chromosomes, with differences observed between human males and human females. Blood type is not only an example of multiple alleles, which means more than two alleles are possible, but also codominance, where more than one dominant allele is expressed when they occur together. Finally, the range of human height we observe is due to the fact that there are multiple genes for height, which makes it a polygenic trait. We will explore how human phenotypes are inherited in our next lab activity.